So children, chemical kinetics deals with the study of the way. Way means the processing, that is the manner in which reaction takes place. So this is the meaning of chemical kinetics. For example, we have vehicles, two-wheelers, four-wheelers, and all the combines, they run on particular fuel. It is petrol, it is diesel, kerosene, or CNG, etc. So this is the meaning of chemical kinetics. In the chemical kinetics, kinetics means the work by any chemical change. So if there is chemical change, so there will be the chemical kinetics. So this is the meaning of chemical kinetics. So children, actually, chemical kinetics involves certain basic points. So first we have to see the graphical representation. If we have this type of representation, we have the axis, and here we have the, you know, on this axis there is the time, and on this axis there is the concentration, concentration of, you know, reactant as well as the product. So this is the point, and we can describe like this. So if we have the concentration, let it be in the mole per liter, and here in the minute inverse. So if we take here the, here we have the reactants, and on this side we have the products. Just this is the concept of, you know, rate of reaction from the class 11. So if reaction is at the start or the start of reaction, so children, the amount of reactants will be maximum, and so amount of product will be minimum or zero at the start of reaction. So as the reaction proceeds, as the reaction moves, what happens? The amount of reactants slowly and slowly decreases, and here amount of products, it will slowly and slowly increase. So this is the point. At this point, the change in the concentration is uniform. Yes, exactly. So, and at this point, here we can say, if the reactants here, A plus B gives rise to C plus D. And so here, the at this point, the two processes, if let this in the case of equilibrium, so it proceeds. So here, at this point, the rate of reaction, and it will become C plus B. And so here, this is increasing. This curve indicates that this point to this point increase in concentration of C and D, and this point indicates decrease in concentration of A and B. So this is the children meaning of chemical kinetics. And so kinetics involves the, you know, change in the reaction, and so this is there, and we have to point, and then we have to say about the different conditions. And so this is the basic point about the chemical kinetics. So children, chemical kinetics involves rate of reaction. So then you have to see the rate of reaction. So rate of reaction simply means the rate at which a reaction takes place, rate at which a reaction takes place. It can be just compared with the speed, you know, speed, distance upon time. So similarly here, the rate, simply we do not write again and again rate of reaction. So rate, it is understood, rate means rate of reaction. So rate is equal to, here we write on the change in concentration upon time taken. So concentration can be, you know, in mole per liter, time can be a minute or second or hour depending on the nature of the reaction. Now, suppose if I take a reaction, let the decomposition of ammonia gas decomposes and the reaction be reversible, and so it forms here, there is the formation of N2 gas, and here there is formation of CH2 gas. So we will balance here. Now children, on the this is the forward side, this is said to be the forward side. Forward side means the reaction which helps, or the way which helps in the condition of the formation of the product. So this is said to be the direction of forward reaction. This is direction of forward reaction, means the decomposition of ammonia to form hydrogen and nitrogen, and this from reactant side to product side, this is the said to be direction of backward reaction. Direction of backward reaction. So the forward reaction and the backward reaction, they have the same speed, children. Generally, there can be difference, but the nutshell is the rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. There is the same speed, they are at the same speed. Rate of backward reaction, rate of forward reaction, they are found to be same, they are found to be equivalent. So this is very important point to note. Now children, we'll see how actually it how proceeds. So if again write down this, and here the sign of reversibility, so there is N2 gas and there is 3H2 gas, and here this is the gas. Now the rate will be written as minus sign, means decreasing the concentration, and here we have the D or delta. This is the NH3, or this is the change in time, dt, and here we write down 1/2. Then here is plus again, here the B means delta, change in concentration, N2, and here we have the dt, and it is equal to plus here 1/3, and this dH2 upon dt. So this is the very important point to note. Why I have done here 1/3? Because see, the reactions takes place at the molecular level, and equimolar amount has to be taken. And that's why we divide here by 3. So by dividing, it will become equal to unity or 1. Similarly here, if it is identity, so it will remain as 1. Here, if the coefficient is 2, so it divided. So all the concentration, the rate of forward reaction, rate of backward reaction, they are taking place at the same speed, and thus we. So this negative sign indicates, this indicates the decrease in concentration. So if you see here, so this indicates decrease in concentration, and this indicates increase in concentration. So this is there about the rate of chemical reaction and rate of kinetics and so on. So this is there.